somehow Prabhupada picked me up out of that society lower than Lakshan and engaged me in Krishna service. So many people Prabhupada picked up. And then Prabhupada, just as here it says, about everyone maybe, Kiva Lipra, Kiva Nasi Sutra Kanimai, Jai Krishna Veta Tattva Se Guru Hoi, Lord Chaitanya says, it doesn't matter who you are, if you're a Brahmin or a Sannyasi or whether you're a Sudra, whatever it may be, in that regard, as Prabhupada, said that whether you're Vihastas or whatever you may be, everybody should take up. Well, here's the mic. I want to get some quotes from Prabhupada speaking in Mayapur. This is during Gaur Purnima Festival, March 16, 1976. Jali Dekho Chali Koho Krishna Pudev, CC Madhya 7.128. Prabhupada, anywhere, either you are in this district or that district, it doesn't matter. Either you are at home or outside home, it doesn't matter. You become a guru. Everyone, how shall I become guru? I have no qualification. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, you don't require any qualification. You simply require one qualification. That you repeat the instructions of Bhagavad Gita. That's all. Janina kota de koho Krishna upadesh. That's all. You become a guru. Don't adulterate Krishna Upadesh like a rascal or nonsense. Present it as it is, Bhagavad Gita. Then you become a guru. You can become a guru in your family. You can guru your society, your nation, wherever you are. And if it is possible, you go outside and preach this mission of Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, our movement's name is Krishna Consciousness. Wherever Krishna says, whatever Krishna says, you accept and preach. You become Guru. Shapopad ki. So we have many preachers here, many Prabhupada direct disciples, many Prabhupada followers, Siksha disciples, grand disciples. Especially for our senior devotees, sometimes we find that we get so many new devotees who are taking up so much responsibility in preaching. And we need to encourage all our devotees, even many people may be in their temples, but then they take Grihastha Ashram, they go into their home. Prabhupada said, doesn't matter, be a guru in your home. We divided, as the congregational minister, we are always trying to create better systems of congregational preaching, promote. We have our Namaharta, the generic kind of all kinds of house programs, regular programs that Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Lord Nityananda started. We don't know all the different kinds of meeting, but in one place Lord Chaitanya said, 5-10 of you get together, clap your hands, chant in your doorsteps. So that inspired us for the Bhakti Riksha program, small groups, where one doesn't have to be very qualified. They can be a facilitator and facilitate the meetings. But now we have from the Chopati, they have started the counselor groups where people are very senior devotees who are counselors for the younger devotees. So different kinds of programs. But almost anyone, like Churi Prabhu from Laguna Beach, he's got some Bhakti Riksha groups, different Prabhupada, one lady disciples here, she told me she has enough happiness on her own. If everybody, even if you're not living in a temple anymore, if you can have some kind of a Navhat program or house program from your home, be a guru for at least the people that you're in association with. I think this will double our movement every year very quickly and keep everybody in the fire. One doesn't have, you see here in Mayapur, we have so many brahmacharis, but a certain percentage of them get married. It's natural, right? Not so many as maybe other places, but a certain percentage get married. When they go home, we insist they have to, if they go home, if they don't stay serving here, insist they have to be part of the Navhat. Some then go home and they spread even 25 Navhata groups in a few years. So somehow we can have a system. Some of our devotees were in a temple, now maybe they're in the home unit, that they should also be preaching. Everybody should keep on preaching. This is a preaching movement. This is all we're meant for. Grihe Thakur, Bone Thakur, Sada Hari Bole Thakur. Whether we're in the house or whether we're in the ashram, preach, preach, preach. Whether distributing books or following up after the book distribution and cultivating the people who got the books, training them, Prabhupada said, we distribute so many books, we need to train the people so they become devotees. So all of you senior devotees that are here, you all have so much knowledge. We're all listening to the nectar. You have got it. Give it. Just like Lord Chaitanya Nita, they gave the mercy. Don't keep it to yourself. We're so grateful you're here giving it to us. And we want you to keep on giving it to whoever you meet. Jari Dako, Tariko, Kishnu Puresh. Everyone you meet, just keep on telling them how wonderful Prabhupada is. How wonderful Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy is. That's the only qualification. Even if we're lower than a sudra or lower than a lecture or whatever, but if we can repeat whatever we heard from Prabhupada and Krishna, that is our qualification. Our only qualification. We don't need any other qualification. And Prabhupada, I mean, he was preaching so heavy. Amazing, some of the things he says. The visible effect of this chanting is that the members of the Hare Krishna movement, regardless of their backgrounds, all give up the four principles of sinful life and come to an elevated standard of devotion. Although past posing as great scholars, ascetics, householders, and swamis, the so-called followers of the Hindu religion are all useless. Dried up branches of the Vedic religion. They are important. They cannot do anything to spread the Vedic culture for the benefit of human society. The essence of the Vedic culture is the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Lord Chaitanya instructed, Jare Dako Tade Ko Kishtu Upadesh Amarad Ki Guru Hoya Tago He Desh. So Prabhupada, he doesn't want us to become dried up twigs either. We have to keep on telling whatever. Even I'm not qualified, I'm not able, but I have to tell you, I learned something from the greatest spiritual master that was here in the modern era. His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Ki. I want to tell you that. Even though I'm not able to follow fully, whatever I'm able to follow, to whatever extent I've understood, it is the most amazing thing. It is the most wonderful message. Prabhupada also said, Chari-lila, one should simply instruct everyone he meets regarding the principles of Krishna Bhakta, as expressed in Bhagavad Gita as it is in Srimad Bhagavatam. One who has no interest in Krishna Kata or the movement of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is like dry useless wood with no living force. The Iskar branch being directly watered by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is becoming undoubtedly successful, whereas the disconnected branches of the so-called Hindu religion that are envious of Iskar are drying out and dying. Adi Lila 12:74. We can revitalize the Hindu religion by just getting all the Hindus to also glorify Krishna. That's the secret. Anybody, whatever religion they're from, whatever, if they glorify the Supreme Personality of God, head, if they do Krishna Kirtan, then they will get the mercy. I wanted to say how my very dear God brother, Tamakrishna Goswami, he was always glorifying Krishna in so many different ways, whether it was here in Mayapur, or whether it was in Radha Damodar party, or whether it was in China, or Philippines, or Dallas, or wherever. He was always thinking of ways. Sometimes, you know, he had different ideas. Some worked out really good, some didn't, but that's what happens in preaching, you try different things. But he was always innovating, always thinking of new ways how to spread Krishna consciousness. And he was the first one to come up with the idea, I think. I may be wrong in which first or second, but anyway, he was one of the first, if not the first, to come up with the idea of creating a temple community, buying the whole city block around the Dallas temple and putting grihastas there. Now we have a few communities where devotees having houses around the temple in Alachua, in Nuchalabon, and I haven't been to Gidanagri for a few years, so I don't know, but maybe there too, I don't know where else. It's like, we heard in Karnataka and Canada, different places, and New Govardhan. But he had that vision first, I think, at least one of the first, anyway, to put it into practice. So he was we really need also all his followers and all those who are his brothers and sisters and followers. We should all be inspired by his determination to preach. I mean, for us, for me, it was a personally great loss. And for all of us, that we were expecting him to do a lot more preaching now that he had got his PhD. But at least to the very the last thing he did was really get us all to do a lot of kirtans. There's an interesting pastime they tell in Ramuna, where his ashram was. And there was a yogi, some tantric yogi, who had learned how to fly on the back of a branch. This would cut down a lot the cost of devotees coming here if you knew this system. They couldn't bring much luggage with them though. But anyway, I'm not promoting that we have to learn that, but if you see anybody flying in on a branch, we'll know. So the villagers all came over to tell Rasikananda, Gurudev, you should see, there's a yogi in the village, he's flying. He's on a branch, he's flying. That time was early in the morning and Rasikananda was brushing his teeth with a neem twig. You know how, I don't know if you've ever problem with a lot of neem twigs to brush his teeth. You get a neem twig about this big, you chew and chew on the end. The juice is very bitter and very good for your whole tray and everything, the digestion and the motions and whatnot, and we don't be too graphic here. But anyway, then you brush your teeth with that brush at the end of the tweet. He said, that's not important. This thing's not important. Another group came, Gurudev, see the guy's flying. He's flying all around the village on a branch. It's really, it's not important. Then a third group came, you know, this time, Gurudev, flying. I never saw a man fly, he's flying. So like Rasikananda, I told you it's not important. It was important, I would have told you about it. He took his twig out from his mouth, put it under his leg, and he started flying around the ashram.